The minimum normal dislocation. As we know already, every line is equal to 0.1. If your patient can read only the first line, he's dislocated 0.1. First and second, 0.2. First, for example, 5 lines, 0.5. Till the 9th line, when dislocated is 0.9. If your patient can read all 10th line, his dislocated is 1. Normal, minimum normal dislocated. Dislocated move may be more than 1. If your patient can read 11th or 12th line, but it's not so interesting for us as for the doctors. Because for us, it's necessary to know normal or less than normal. If normal, it's not necessary to examine the patient. If less than normal, it's necessary to determine why and explain why. Numbers of refraction, other disorders of the eye, and so on. So, distance for examination, 5 meters. We examine both eyes separately because different dislocations may be different on both eyes. All the examination, not only this one, we start with the right eye. So we use special cover, we give the patient the cover, cover left eye because we start with the right eye, and show the patient legs. We start just from the 10th line. If the patient can read the 10th line, you will stop, say visual acuity of the right eye is 1, and that's all. You understand, if the patient can read small letters, of course he can read all above. Mm-hmm. It's not necessary to show all one by one. If your patient will say, no, I can't see this line, 10th line, or amount of mistakes will be rather large, you should start from the very beginning and show lines one by one, till the moment when the patient will say, no, I can't see the next line. The last line which the patient can read, it will be his visual acuity. Or amount of mistakes will be more than possible. About these mistakes, possible amount of mistakes. In first and second line, must be no mistakes at all. For example, if your patient will read Shabbe without any mistakes, but in the second line will make even one mistake, for example, instead of M and K, he will read M and E. One mistake? No, we don't use this line for interpretation of the patient's vision, so his visual acuity will be 0.1, not more. In lines from 3rd to 6th, it's possible to make one mistake. Line with one mistake, we use. Two mistakes, no, to use the previous one. And in lines from 7th to 10th, it's possible to make two mistakes. So, if your patient will read the 10th line even with two mistakes, his visual acuity still will be 1. Normal. Not full, but normal. You understand, yes? And it's not necessary to show all the lines above. So two mistakes and 10th line is possible. After every test of skills during your credit test, you should make a conclusion. In the case of visual acuity, it will be the result. Visual acuity of the right eye is 1. Visual acuity of the left eye is 0.7.
Should we say normal or abnormal?
No, no.
Okay.
Just the result. Please sit here. What do you prefer in your group? Do you know the Russian letters?
Yes.
Okay, let's see. You know the Russian letters? Train.
Okay, ja.
For tomorrow.
I know it, can I?
Then. How you buy food? Without.
No, same Chinese food.
Now let's change the person. Another situation, yes, person which has my do you see the sign? No. Do you see the sign? Also no. Yeah? If your patient can read, continue to the moment when he will say can't see, yes? But if your patient can't read even the first line, his visual acuity less than 0.1. Mm-hmm. In this case, it's necessary to use Snellen formula, or the so-called finger counting test. Mm-hmm. In your practical skill list, it's